Hi, this is Preeti from Analytics India Magazine. Welcome back to another episode from the segment My Journey into Data Science with Netali Agarwal. Netali Agarwal has close to 10 years of professional experience and she specializes in data science, business analytics and business intelligence. She has also published a paper on use of predictive analytics in the world of cricket and it has also been selected for national level artificial intelligence and machine learning conference. So let's go ahead and talk to Netali Agarwal about her journey and also if she were to hire a data scientist for her team, what skills would she look at and her advice to data science aspirants. Before we go ahead, we would like to apologize for the quality of the video recording. It was the best we could do under the current lockdown circumstances, but we have added subtitles for your convenience. So let's get into it. Coming to the first question, what do you work as and what is it that you do?
I'm working as a data scientist with Infosys and working in supply chain analytics domain. So my work journey starts from getting the business requirement till end of model creation. So complete data science journey I am part of.
How long have you been working as a data scientist?
It has been around 5 to 6 years for me to be working as a data. Means I transition slowly, but now it is a full-fledged data science role. Okay. So if you just from the start point, it has been around 5.5 years.
Talking about your transition, you moved from a software system engineer to a data scientist. How did that happen?
So actually, I got interested in intrude with the data part because I was working in a very old technology that was mainframe. So it is pretty much old. So I didn't want to build my career just over there. So it started that the world was towards data. So I started learning on my own all these analytics and ML part and all that. And finally, within my project, I started doing POC. And it was well appreciated with my managers within my team itself. And then finally, I took up a PG diploma course with Great Lakes Institute of Management to get a certification so that it will add more value. So since then, I was pretty much recognized in the organization also as a data scientist.
Coming to the next question, how did you manage your time while working as well as pursuing a diploma at the same time?
Actually, it is every time, not just now, it will continue. Means it was not just past, not just present or future. There is a learning curve for a data scientist at every point of time. I tell to each one whom I mentor or whom I meet also that you have to get your hands dirty and continue getting your hands dirty. If you stop that, saying, oh, now data scientist, I need not do anything, then that's where your journey stops. Your success journey stops, I would say. So you have to take out time somewhere or the other. I used to take out my time in the morning, get up early or study late at night. So somehow or the other, I have to manage that.
I think this is a question that our viewers would want to know. If you were to hire a data scientist for your team, what would be the distinguishing qualities that you would look at? Would it be their educational qualification, their skill sets, their projects?
It's always a mix of both because you can't, it is not something that you have to be great in every field. Someone would be great in something, some other would be in another thing. That will definitely happen. But for me, if I have to select a data scientist, for me, things goes like this, that person should have worked on, should be conceptually clear. Because if you are conceptually clear, then only you can tell what is the difference between right and wrong. But people who just do copy paste or just they will learn one or two things and they will tell that we are the data scientists, we can easily get a batch of them. They are not the right product for any company. So you should keep on practicing as and when always. And that is also from initial phase, from every phase. It is not just the machine learning. I say statistics also, exploratory data analysis also. Each part a data scientist should practice. And that is the 80% your descriptive and diagnostic analytics that make the data science cycle. So you should practice more on that and emphasize more on that. They are very basic building blocks. And if I am recruiting anyone, I make sure that person should be very, very clear on these basic concepts. Otherwise, it is a no-no profile for me.
Lastly, what advice would you give to data science aspirants?
Definitely, there is one mantra which I follow, and that is torture the data and data will confess to you. So that a data scientist will understand this thing, that you have to do a very good exploratory data analysis. As I said, you have to do the initial part very clear and very rigorously then only you will land up with a good model. So what people do is just directly jump to machine learning and artificial intelligence, but that's not data science. It is just subset of data science. So do the initial is very clearly, practice it, clear your conceptual understanding, then only you will succeed.
Thank you so much for being a part of this show. It's been an absolute delight. With that, we come to the end of this video. Don't forget to subscribe to Analytics India magazine and follow this segment for everything in the world of data science. See you soon. Bye.